the talks I had this morning, the practice of advancing clocks started in 1916 with the World War in order to save energy, energy resources, I should say, like coal. And then in 1944, daylight saving time was abandoned to be reset in 75 when the price of oil skyrocketed. Darkness falls at a later time. For some, it's a gift after a long winter of dark evenings. But for the night owls, maybe not. It's good for business, but will we keep it? Will we drop it? The government will decide if it's worth disrupting the body's natural clock. I read somewhere that an old Native American said, only the government would believe that you could cut a foot of the blanket, set it to the bottom, or sew it to the bottom, and have a longer blanket. Here we are, Vito Ricci and Lise Vacheron, on this March 12th. So we are going to play some piano pieces that Vito wrote, inspired by Anne Hunt Currier, a photographer from Brooklyn. Photographs out of her window one winter, and there are 14 of them. So you have 14 views of those from that window in the winter. Let's see. Thank you. it's rare that one sits to listen to his own music. For me, it's a pleasure to listen to these views one after the other. It's been a long time. So that helped you wake up. Don't do what this clock does in front of us. It says 9:27, but it's not. It's 10:27, remember. So these pieces were played by Martin Goldray, Vito's music, and inspired by photographs. You could check Anne Hunt Courier, check her website and see some beautiful photographs. .com, of course. Yeah, websites are always .com, no? I think so. All right, so now we are going to listen to Manhattan Transfer. We're getting into spring. And then you'll hear a piece by a Canadian-Chinese composer called Yu Su and a few others. So let's do it. Let's start it. Stop it right now, and I will.
We sing the spring, what? Sing joy, spring. A rare and most mysterious spring.
This most occult thing is buried deep in the soul. Its story never has been told. The joy spring, the fount of pleasure, is deep inside you whether you think it or not. Once you're aware of this spring, you'll know that it's the greatest treasure you got. And furthermore, the joy spring, the bounteous treasure, cannot be bartered away, never can be sold. Nothing can take it from you. It's yours and yours alone to have it, to hope. And something more, it never is lost. To fire a threat, it's always around. When trouble is gone, the pleasure is left. I always have found a sprinkle of proof, same as a treasure man lays up in heaven, worth a price no one can measure. That says a lot. The joy spring, the fountain of pleasure, is deep inside you, let me inform you of truth. Once a delay on this, when he was searching for the fountain of youth.
Once a delay on love so much he never did find the magic fountain. But many people with a well-adjusted spirit, they could hear it when you told them it was there. Telling them was like telling it on the mountain. It's quite a lift to having the gift of laughter. I'm a man who knows in a minute. I can tell you just exactly how the story goes. It evolves a firm conviction in another previous life, giving your mind a chance to fly. Fly around the universe, investigating other galaxies and surrender sometimes life, and you can get pretty well acquainted with a lot of other strife. And pretty much acquiring yourself plenty of education. Pretty soon becomes Earth, birth, and then you're ready to put it all to work. As soon as you finish being born, you start forgetting what you knew. Cause you're another kind of you, a reincarnation, manifestation, spirit and sensation.
You really got that right! Person isn't bright, not so bright that they recall the fatal fall. Down here to this earth, their minds disguised to death, the spirit life and call it birth. That's their reason for forgetting, and they find it very upsetting when reminded. Tell them they've lived before, they'll show you the nearest open door. Gotta have feeling while dealing with walkers in their sleep. They can't imagine something as deep. Here they come, here they come, here they are. I'd imagine living or falling from the star. Here they come, here they are, here they go. Life is over in a minute, and they never dig it in or enjoy a minute of it, cause they put too much of bubble, it's gross. Something's worth a couple of bucks at the most. So there's a reason that the maker of man included there with his plan. A certain fountain deep within where there was laughter, youth, and gold for human beings to have and hold and share the memory of where we've all been. Brothers called grim new chances, the slim anybody would dig that the human soul was snow white and the seven dwarfs and seven tempers in man. Who's digging out the gold completes the plan. And Bacon was hip that Shakespeare couldn't read, and so he gave him all the rhymes that have lasted through the years and kept eternal truths alive through several centuries. That's how we know them now. Then as it caused the truth, what was it from Macbeth? Life's but a walking shadow, a play of poor that struts and frets upon the stage and see no more. A tale that truly has an idiotic ring that's full of lots of sound and fury signifying nothing. That's right, signifying nothing. I repeat it, nothing. Don't forget it, nothing. And that's the reason for the spring of joy that the Father put inside of every single girl and boy. Mm-hmm. the stage, it's showtime. Everyone on and proceed to act your age.
Whatever you brought on out is funny enough, I'll laugh until you're wasting all your humor on a frown while you bring the spirit down.
You gotta book yourself a comic in your act. Without some laughter, life's some maudlin parts, and that's a fact.
Once you have got the spring, you always can smile. It becomes your one expression, and you always wear it like the Buddhas do.
We sing the spring,
sing joy spring,
a rare and most mysterious spring.
This most occult thing is buried deep in the sun.
Yes, story never has been told.
The joy spring, the fountain of pleasure, is deep inside you whether you dig it or not. But you're aware of this spring, you know that it's the greatest treasure you've got. And furthermore, the joy spring, the finest treasure, cannot be bottled away and never can be sold. Nothing can take it from you. It's yours and yours alone to have it, to hold. And something more, if never is lost, to fire a theft. It's always around when trouble is gone, the pleasure is left. I always around, it's burglar proof, same as the treasure man. Lives up in heaven with a price no one can measure. That says a lot to just bring about the pleasure. It's deep inside you, let me inform you, no truth. Also to lay on salt. When he was searching for the fountain of youth, I say in truth he saw the magic clothing, for he was searching for the joy spring.
The watermelon woman now. You should. Thank you.
got me feeling like a horse that never left the post. I lie in my room, staring up at the ceiling. Spring can really hang you up the most. Morning's kiss wakes trees. Just to kill lonely hours. Spring can really hang you up in the most. Love came my way. It would last. We had a day. Now it's all in the past. Spring came along, a season of song. That spring is a bore. Doctors once prescribed a tonic sulfur and molasses was the dose. Can really hang you up the most. All alone, the party's over. Old man went to wars, a precious heart. Snow to hide the clover. Spring can really hang you up the most.
Spring with Betty Carter. Now let's listen to Messiaen, a French composer. And the birds are singing spring. Yes, Olivier Messiaen loved birds and knew them very well, so you can hear it in his music. We are going now, it's the end of the winter, we were really like into spring coming, but we've got some winter poems. that are written in the form of haiku by a Japanese writer, Yuko Otomo, who is here in New York. And one winter she wrote, in fact, 1 year, she wrote poems for haiku for every day. And Vito wrote music to each one of them. So we'll hear a few here. So Vito and Yuko Otomo's haiku. And oh, that's right, I sing them. I haven't listened for a while. I hope they're, yes.
As I stand on my toes, winter sky loosens into a mandala. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes. So, spring is coming. We've changed the time, but it's also the month of women. So I thought that why wouldn't we read a poem by Nikki Giovanni, and it's called A Poem of Friendship. So I'll read it to you. We're not lovers because of the love we make, but the love we have. We're not friends because of the laughs we spend, but the tears we save. I don't want to be near you for the thoughts we share, but the words we never have to speak. And I will never miss you because of what we do, but what we are together. Thank you. piece from Symphony for Amiga that Vito Ricci composed with this, it's an old program, huh? Laura Spiegel's program, and he composed this, and it came out. Music Mouse, that's right. Just a few years ago. So now we are going to, and it was a lotus leaf floats on the lake. Now we're going to a young Frenchman from Brittany, who is a visual artist as well as a musician, and his name is Shelter, and he has just released many tracks on Séance Centre or Séance Center in Toronto. So let's listen to Grey Green Cycles. Shelter. Nice piece. Whoop, well, let me just stop this. Yes, it stopped. No, it's not stopped. Now it is. All right. We are going to now listen to the Flux String Quartet. Vito wrote this string quartet. You know, we want to keep our parents forever, most of us, but they die at some point. And when your parents die and they're the only ones that you knew in the family, they are your family. That's it. Well, then you don't know where you come from. And so Vito called this piece, I Don't Know Who I Am.
Thank you. Yes. I don't know who I am. That was Vito Ricci's music. We are now going to some rare recordings that are not released in the United States, and that I'm singing some songs of mine. And let's listen.
Ça n'arrive pas tous les jours d'aller si haut. quel beau jour. Sur le sommet de la colline, ma tasse déborde de musique, quel beau jour. Sur le sommet de la colline, ma tasse déborde de musique, quel beau jour.
Bob's whim. It was his birthday this week. Bob Holman, the king of slam poetry.
people talk to themselves
when they sit all around all day. This old woman I knew, I used to go over there and sit with her. And she'd be sitting around in a rocking chair talking to herself. And she used to say, sometimes the cold gets in my bones so bad till I just don't think I can go on. Yeah, and for a little while, well, I don't care if my days are coming to an end, I'd just as soon be gone sometimes. Sometimes the night comes down on me and I know what's ahead. An evening in this cold old house with no one to say goodnight to me when I go to bed. An evening in this cold old house with no one to say goodnight to me when I go to bed. Sometimes I wonder why I stay, what am I waiting for? My children are grown and gone away, they got children of their own now, don't need me anymore. In the winter when the streets are bare, there are nothing much to see. I just can't help missing and thinking about that kindly man that one old winter time came and took away from me. And then one morning, another spring is there outside my door. Things are blooming, birds are singing, and suddenly, yes, well, I ain't sad no more. Heart's restored. I've had my love, I've had my children, and I have so many memories. So don't mind me complaining what the years may bring, 'cause this old world has been fine with me, really. And I'm thankful for seeing another spring. It's gonna be better this time. Another spring. It's gonna be groovier this time. Another spring. It's what's happening this time. So I'm thankful for letting me see another spring.